Greetings, everyone. Sean Ruggiero, Managing Partner, Integrity Marketing Group, and President of the Advanced Market Sales Team for Family First Life. We've been talking about IULs, specifically a series of four reasons why every agent should have an IUL. And we're doing this during a time, October of 2021, that we have declared as IUL Awareness Month for Family First Life. It's important that you understand the value of IULs. I believe every agent should have an IUL. I own one, my friends own one, other agents I know own them, our employees own IULs. They're a great supplemental tool to what we do as building our financial capital, getting ready for retirement, and all the other things that go along with that. In a previous episode, we talked about IULs benefit number one, increased death benefit. The statistics show, and I see it firsthand, most agents don't have enough death benefit. And an IUL, especially one with a nice extra term rider, is a great way to affordably purchase extra death benefit that then has cash value that works for you. But the second benefit that we're going to talk about today is the one that probably gets the most praise, the most acclaim, and it is a very powerful benefit, and that is the tax-free retirement. So let's talk about the tax-free retirement, reason number two why you should own an IUL. Now, I'm going to show you some stats. This was pulled from a previous slide showing the U.S. national debt, what its unfunded liabilities are. Let me put this into a different perspective that you can understand. I think your clients should understand, too, when you speak with them. We are currently running a debt load that we can't manage in the United States. All right. On top of that, for the coronavirus, the COVID-19 relief, the U.S. spent, authorized, $9.5 trillion, of which they know they can't afford, they set about $7.5 trillion to debt. What that does is when you add $7.5 trillion to our national debt, and what we do is we pay it off, we pay the interest on it and we sell it off as treasury bonds, you know, 30-year treasury bonds, which are currently yielding around 2%. What we do is we pay the interest only. With this influx of $7.something trillion, if you look at the interest only payments, I'm gonna show it this way, okay, with the graphic. This is what we can afford. This line is like our revenue, it's the government's revenue. This is the increased debt load. When you add in that increased debt load from the COVID relief, by 2025, the estimates show right around that age, right around that time, excuse me, the interest-only payments will exceed what we even make. That's crazy, right? Let me put it in another perspective. If we spent $9.5 trillion just on COVID, what does that really mean to our budget? Well, in 2019, the entire U.S. government federally collected taxes of about $3.5 trillion. Wait, what? And they still have to fund welfare programs and infrastructure and, oh, the military. And do you see what I'm getting at? It is way too much money. What does that mean? Taxes will go up. Taxes will go up. Oh, you don't know exactly. Yes, taxes will go up. Right? I don't want to get on a soapbox here, but think about the United States of America. Think about we are hundreds of years old, and we have lots of things we can sell off and money that we can print. But look at the other countries that are older, that are thousands of years old. Look at Italy, look at Germany, look at France, look at the UK. Their marginal tax rates start around 45% and climb upwards from there. Do you really think we're going to be able to have our tax rates stay as low as they are? The answer is no, not when we have that type of debt. Moving forward, let's look at a history of the marginal income tax levels. Okay, so 1915, actually they passed the, what was it? Oh, which amendment? I don't want to screw this up. The 19th Amendment? Maybe the 9th Amendment. I apologize, check that. But the amendment that allowed us, because it's not in the original Constitution, to actually have the federal government tax you. So they passed an amendment. It was in preparation for World War I, and now tax rates go up. We fight, we win the war, tax rates come down. What happens? We have another world war. Tax rates go up. They stay up, and they stay fairly high all the way through the 60s and the 70s. Now they come down into the early 90s, and then throughout this time period, they've stayed relatively low. sub 40% for top marginal tax brackets. Where will they be in the future? Ask yourself, will they stay the same? Will they go down? Will they go up? They're gonna go up. So insulating yourself from taxes is a very good idea. The other thing that you never hear people talk about though is not just your income tax, but something called your provisional tax footprint. Provisional tax footprint, Social Security. See, Social Security is a great form of income, but it's going to be taxed. And yes, I know you already paid tax on that money, but you're going to be taxed again on your Social Security depending on what your income is. See, people don't talk about that. When we talk about Roth IRAs, when we talk about IULs, one of the most powerful benefits is being able to avoid taxes on your Social Security. So look, if we were married filing jointly and we were collecting Social Security, if our provisional income, which I have videos, you can email us info@fflams.com if you want a video that explains this. It's also in my book, The 7 Benefits of FIAs for Retirement. But if our household income is less than $32,000, we pay 0% on our Social Security. You pay nothing. They say, yeah, you're not making enough money, no tax to you on your Social Security. Now, if we pay over $32,000 up to $44,000, half your Social Security is taxed as income. And then the final number is greater than $44,000. Which there's lots of retired couples that their AJR, their provisional tax footprint is going to put them greater than $44,000. They now pay 85%. But could you imagine if all your supplemental retirement income came from something like a Roth or an IUL and it was tax-free? You would be less than $32,000 and all your Social Security would be untaxed. So think about that. Very powerful thing for you and for your clients. I want to go to the next slide. So what are your savings options? Okay, if you're gonna look to retire, what are your savings options? Well, you have after-tax options, like a brokerage account, savings, CDs. You have tax-deferred options, like annuities, okay? These are all non-qualified. Then you have our qualified options. These are our defined contribution plans, like a 401k or a traditional IRA. You can do a Roth IRA, or if you want something that falls tax-free, you can do permanent valued life insurance. Now, life insurance is not qualified, but any of these pre-tax and tax-free other than life insurance are gonna fall under qualified funds. So after-tax money, tax-deferred money, pre-tax money, and tax-free. And when we get to tax-free, we're really only talking about Roth IRAs and IULs or life insurance. So, here's what I'm gonna show you. This is North American, one of our newer carriers, but when it comes to maximizing tax-free income, North American right now is leading the pack. So we took that 30-year-old female that we used in a previous demonstration, and she doesn't even have the highest rating. She has a preferred, not premier, and we put her at $500 a month. So she's putting in $6,000 a year to supplement her retirement. By age 65, she is done paying, okay? She has paid a total of $216,000 into this policy over the course of 36 years, all right? 35, 36 years. She immediately, look at this, she immediately turns around and takes out $108,000 plus, tax-free every single year. Think about that, tax-free every single year. Oh, by the way, her death benefit has climbed to over $1 million, right around $1.1 million. So she puts in $6,000 a year, a total of $216,000, a little less than a quarter million. She immediately starts to take out $108,000. Now pause there for a second. Over the course of 36 years, she puts in $216,000. The very next year, she takes out almost half of it, literally. $108,000. So year one in retirement, she's taking out half of all the contributions she's put in, and she does that for the rest of her life. And oh, by the way, she has $1 million of death benefit and almost $1 million of cash value to work with. Extremely powerful. Let's fast forward to age 90. At age 90, let's say she dies. She still didn't put in more than $216,000. She took out $2.6 million tax-free. Still has $85,000 of cash to work with and a $336,000 tax-free benefit that will go to her children. And yes, it can be used to borrow money to pay for college, to remodel the house. This side right here, you can borrow against the death benefit. Okay, and it does not take away from the cash value, by the way. That's a very cool thing about North American. It's an indemnity that doesn't take away from the cash value. So you can borrow against the death benefit. It doesn't affect the cash value. And you can pay for long-term care costs, in-home nursing, whatever it might be. Or if she dies and passes it on, it's now a tax-free death benefit, helping with estate taxes, helping with future planning. So North American, fantastic product. And benefit number two is the tax-free ability to protect your provisional income, your Social Security income, to protect yourself against future taxes, and to create a supplemental retirement. And you saw right there, those are pretty nice numbers and very realistic too. Don't forget, North American has this ability. I'm using the National Life Group slide we did from the first one. Don't forget, you still have to protect that human capital during that time. So add a 10-year million-dollar term, $31 a month. Add a 15, $36 a month. Protect your human capital while you're building the financial capital. You can add those on to a North American policy or National Life Group policy or whatever it might be. Don't forget that. All right. So get moving. Benefit number two, benefit number one, two more benefits coming. And remember, the Swiss Army knife of financial tools. It's a great video. Make sure you have an IUL on yourself. Make sure you're learning this. You're preaching what you have, and you're helping clients out. If you have questions, if you need illustrations, if you need help contracting, please email info@fflams.com or call us 208-551-5015. Thank you.